Dead. Greetings, everybody. I am Lissa Mahalik. This is my lovely assistant, Napoleon Bony Parts, and this is our daily dance break. Every day, every weekday, we come in here at 11:45 a.m. Eastern Standard. We do put replays up because a lot of people have been saying, wait, that's 1 a.m. for me. That's okay, we do replays. I'm a somatic movement therapist. What I do is I use the mind-body connection to heal physical pain for the most part. And I'm using my skills here because frankly, I think this is what we bloody well need right now. So if you know anybody out there who also needs it, then pass the word and, hey guys, and let them know about this. So in somatics, generally what somatics does is it makes the mind-body connection explicit and conscious instead of implicit and unconscious. And that's what we're gonna do today. We start out with a couple of moves that are designed to kick on the mind-body connection, and then we're gonna shake our butts, keeping that connection in mind. Now today's a little weird because we've been up through the past few days, we've been moving up through the chakras, and now here we are at the third eye chakra. And a lot of the movements with third eye are not so much big and expansive like we had when we were doing solar plexus. Wow, here I am, I'm out in the world, I'm taking action. You know, root chakra, that's pretty straightforward. Here we are connecting with the earth. But with this one, it's a lot of breathing and internal stuff. So imagine we're taking this more like an internal martial art. We've been doing kung fu and now we're coming in and doing qigong. So I do a lot of martial arts. What can I say? All right, so in somatics, the most important thing is that your experience in your body is paramount. If you are not feeling the same things as I'm saying, oh, you should be feeling this, that's okay. It's your damn experience in your body and nobody can take that from you. So keep that in mind. In somatics, all metaphors are real. So what you are feeling, it's real, honey. Absolutely real. All right, so again, anybody who needs to hear this, share this with your friends. Our movements du jour for that third eye. The third eye is about I imagine. And one of the things I'd like to invite you guys to imagine today is what happens after this? Once we get out, what is this brave new world that we can create? Because we can. We can create some amazing things. We are changing the world fundamentally right now. What is going to be the next new paradigm? Let's make it awesome. Starting out, take your hands, make a little dome with your hands, and bring it right here to the base of your diaphragm. And as you inhale, bring your hands down, flatten them. And as you exhale, let them come out. Now the third eye is all about going into the unconscious and connecting with that deep, deep internal parasympathetic nervous system. You can follow me here, you can follow your own breathing, whatever works. So as you inhale and bring it down, and exhale, we're contacting literally the pineal gland. It's kind of back in the back of the head as a third eye. There are literally light sensing cells in there. It's what regulates our sleep cycle, produces melatonin, and it's actually the part of the body that Descartes used to think, wait, maybe this is the physical connection of the mind and the body. No, honey, it's all round, but that's a thing. So as you breathe into our parasympathetic nervous system, we contact that part of the body that the pineal gland directly influences. So contacting the parasympathetic nervous system, feel how things start to change in your mind. As we do that, shift your breathing and breathe up into your nose, into this upper part of your skull here. This is where the pineal gland is located, so breathe up and back. And breathing up and back. And breathing up and back. And breathing up and back. Now connect the front of the rib cage here. Inhaling. And exhale. Breathing forward and back. And exhale. Breathing forward and back. And exhale. One more time. Forward and back. And exhale. Bring in your sacrum. Put your hands down here on your sacrum and inhale back into your sacrum as you inhale. And exhale. Inhaling back into your sacrum. And exhale. Inhaling back. And down. And one more time, inhaling back. And now as you inhale, you're gonna inhale all three places at the same time. Inhaling back into your sacrum, forward into the front of your rib cage, and back into the top of your skull. So inhaling. And down, you're activating your whole spine, your whole parasympathetic nervous system. And exhale, and one more time, inhaling. Your whole system is present, it's aware, it's alive, it's amazing. Keep that expansion with the breath and release through the exhale. So inhaling, expand, and exhale, and expand, and exhale, and keep going, and exhale. Add a little movement, a little full body movement, a little rise as you inhale, and exhale. You can move your arms here, sacrum, ribs, head. Inhale. What do you imagine? Hold that image and move. Keep the breaths flowing. Inhale. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, pause, hold that. How do you imagine the new world? Inhale. Whatever you need to move right now, move with that breath. And breathe. And exhale. And exhale. In. Breathe down to center. Bring your palms of your hands together. Press. Stop. Press the palms of your hands together. There we go. Inhale and exhale. Feel the breath going through the top of your skull, through the front of your rib cage, through the base of your spine. Feel the breath running right up the very front of your spine, behind your heart, behind your throat. Anytime you're working with the glands or the chakras, you want to make sure that you are activating the entire spine afterwards, because the glands are where the crazy lives. If you open up just one of them, the crazy comes out, and that's not pretty. When you activate all of them up and down the spine, then you ground, you center, and you make everything happy and alive and awake. So as you press down, feel the palms of your hands pressing together. Feel the circle of bone, the bones of your forearms the bones of your upper arms, the bones of your shoulder blades, the bones of your rib cage. And as you inhale again deep, feel how your rib cage expands with the inhale and releases with the exhale. Feel the energy flowing down your spine into your tailbone, out into your hip sockets, down into your legs, into the earth. Your toes are roots going down into the planet. Now I'm gonna say, take your hands, reach them down to the inside of your feet. You can bend all the way over, but I don't know if everybody can see my hands. You're gonna draw up the energy up the insides of your legs, up the center of your spine, up and out into the rest of the universe, and down. And again, down to the earth, draw that power up, up the front of your spine, up and out to the rest of the universe. It sinks down to the earth. It gets cleansed and fired up and right back in. Bring your hands to the base of your rib cage in the back. We've been doing a lot with the front of the ribs. And inhale back and exhale. Inhale up from your feet into your kidneys right here. And exhale. And one more time, inhaling back into your kidneys. And exhale, bring your hands to your center, pressing against each other, reaching your elbows up, bringing your shoulder blades down. Feel that circle of bone around here. This is the expansion, protecting the heart in front. The rib cage and bones protect the heart and back. Everything is awesome. We are here. It is now. We are taking care of ourselves so we can take care of each other, so we can take care of others and reach out. Now, this is Friday, so that means we don't have another session until Monday. So, again, if you've enjoyed this, if you have friends who need this, go forth and share it with them. Today, we're kind of bringing it down and making it chill. On Monday, we're gonna fire back up again. We're gonna go out to the universe with the crown chakra. It's gonna be super fun. And then we've got even more amazing things coming up this week. So, enjoy your anatomy. If you're not enjoying your anatomy, sometimes stuff kind of comes up during this. That's okay. So feel free to ping me if it does. We'll talk about it. Enjoy your anatomy. I will see you guys Monday. Have a freaking fantastic weekend. And stop. Bye-bye, Instagram.